First, we see a chart that represents the AC symmetrical fault current off of a typical generator. We can see that the output of the fault current does decay over time, but this is only one variable in a fault current contribution. Another variable is the DC component, which rapidly decays over just a few cycles. And if we combine the AC and DC component, we get the total asymmetrical fault current. What we're looking at today is not the asymmetrical fault current, but rather just the AC symmetrical component. So we're going to ignore the DC component, and we're just going to be calculating the symmetrical fault current. And to do that, we'll use an example of a typical generator that's 800 kW with a 0.8 power factor, 480 volt, and a subtransient reactance of 0.12. So first we need to calculate the kVA, and we do that by just dividing the kilowatts by the power factor, so we get a 1000 kVA generator. Next, we want to calculate the full load amps, or FLA, so we take the kVA and divide it by the square root of 3, assuming that it's a three-phase generator, and we times it by the line-to-line voltage, which would be 480 in this case. And so we get an FLA of 1202, and next we take that FLA and divide it by the subtransient reactance, and we get a fault current of 10,017 symmetrical amps. So in this case, we would need a circuit breaker or fuse that has an interrupt rating above 10,000. And we want to always add in a little cushion, so maybe we'd have something that was, if it was a circuit breaker, perhaps a 14,000 interrupt rating, or a fuse that probably is much higher anyway, so it's probably not an issue. And calculating the fault current off of a generator is, as you can see, actually quite easy to get the basic symmetrical fault current.